Okay, it's 11 o'clock, February 29th, which people call leap day, or leap year, whatever the hell you want to call it, 2016. Because of the freedoms we really don't have, but we have somewhat, we're still out here. I was watching a video I shared earlier. I was looking at, someone had shared it, and guy was cussing from a drainage way, it looked like. You know, people always talking like we, you know, not like we, because I understand it, about growing healthy food and all that. And well, here's my take on that. We have plastic on soil that all that used to be grass. It used to be part of the yard. And I tilled it all up with the landlord, the owner of the land's permission. We've been very fortunate that we have this location here where we can do such a thing. And put plastic on there because plastic inhibits a little bit of the rain that comes down. But again, it all goes into the ground regardless. So, you know, what's up in the sky comes down. They've been spraying their skies for about 40, 50, maybe even 60, 70 years. Toxins, pollutions, and a lot of people, you know, I'm trying not to cuss because, you know, I cuss a lot when I see these creatures up in the air spraying the stuff that they spray with no regard to you. It's not like they don't know, because, you know, you'd be a really stupid person if you actually think you're driving a car and you don't know who's in your car, what's in your trunk. And if you do it, then you really, really, really are stupid. But anyway, they spray stuff onto it gets above the clouds. It's usually above the real clouds, what's left of those even. And eventually it comes down to the ground in form of rain. So you go to the store and you're buying, I'm buying organic, you know. And I would say probably, and I'm not saying I know for a fact, I would say 99% of the organic stuff you're buying is probably outside in gardens, you know. It might be the best intentions, with like we have heirloom seeds from Heirloom Solutions, and it's one of the healthiest types of vegetables you're going to have. The vegetables that we grow are still going to be 10 times better than the crap you're going to buy in the store. Okay, because you don't know where they're going, and they spray stuff on it to ship it, and how they handle it, and you get these pickers from other countries because Americans don't want to do that work, which is another lie that the stupid people believe. The lesser of the evil is like voting for a Republican mafia family or a Democrat mafia family, the D.C. mafia. You think you're getting the lesser of two evils. They both work for the same agenda. Jesus, please, please stop showing your ignorance by believing that shit, okay? I'm going to say it right, go, but I'm sorry. Anyway, we put the plastic down. It heats the ground up. It gives it about almost 10 degrees or better in the wintertime. I'm sure it warms up maybe even warmer than that in the summertime, which shouldn't restrict most of the things we grow. But we tilled up the back half 18 inches deep last fall, right before the end of the tilling or anything. And then in another couple, 3 weeks, well, actually in about a week, I'm going to till my band. I'm going to go around here and I'm going to put torch sunflowers, the orange ones. And they're yellow sunflowers. I'm going to have them on three sides of the garden, okay? Finger here. You know, all around, all the way to the back, along the back, and then up the front. And in the front section, I was going to put more sunflowers over there, but I have other flowers from Solutions from Science, or Heirloom Solutions, too. They're basically, they work together at the same place. But it's different flowers that help attract butterflies and hummingbirds and honeybees. So that's the whole reason for putting the sunflowers around the garden like we did last year. We just had a little section over there. And we had developed flowers and stuff on other plants that need to be pollinated. Some of the stuff didn't go out too well. The tomatoes never came out very well. I mean, we had decent. I mean, not even decent. On a 1 to 10, with 10 being great, we probably had about a 2 on the tomatoes. Bought some from one of the chain stores that was said it was heirloom. They got a few tomatoes off that, probably about 5 or 6 of them. And then the tomato plants I put out came up as big, if not bigger, than those. But then the hornworms, which is a really nasty insect you have to watch for to keep your tomatoes growing healthy and without being ruined, because they'll decimate a plant in about a day. One day, really, seriously. They did it to a couple pepper plants we had, too. But the plastic, it alleviates, in my mind at least, it's not all getting saturated with the contaminated chemtrailed rain. So it is getting in there regardless. There's nothing we can really do about that, per se. Unless I had the money, which I don't, to make a glass greenhouse out here. You know, I would think that my landlord would allow that, because it wouldn't be nothing that would destroy anything. It would be before the betterment of the property. And if we are here for another 10 years, it would be great. You know, 20 years, if I lived that long, I doubt it, but it's possible. It would be nice to have a greenhouse out here to protect it from that crap. We have well water, which groundwater, again, gets contaminated too. So we're living in a toxic country for it to be as supposedly such a developed nation. So you can take out what you want out of all that, but, you know, Of 10 being the worst crap, that's what's in most all your stores. You know, China Mart, which is one of the biggest ones, they get the cheapest crap. Oh, but we've got organic, which again, it's 99% chance it's going to be grown outdoors anyway. So, you know, unless they're in a greenhouse, which is rare, and they'll pass the cost along to you. But we try to do the best we can with our heirloom seeds out here. We plant tomatoes and all that in the house. We got a bunch growing now, peppers. And a lot of things that are going to go directly into the ground. Probably about another, this is the 29th of February. I'd say about 3 weeks from now, I might start planting some things because the weather's starting to break a little bit. But by Thursday, when I get, hopefully, knock on wood, disability, that's all I'm living on right now. The government basically got me where they got what they want. Most people dependent on what they give you. You know, even though you paid into it, and it's your money. Technically, it is, but they'll sit there and say, "Well, we ain't got it because we gotta have more defense and all this other BS and stuff." Anyway, I'm not gonna go off in that. Maybe then by Thursday, I will till that up all the way on the three sides up to CJ's grave over there, and if I can get CJ's grave, I can't see it because of the gas propane tank over there. But CJ's grave over there is in the back. Anyway, and put the sunflowers in the torch sunflower seeds out there so that they can, you know, start mix up real good, you know, the soil, put the seeds. I'm going to try to spread them out a little bit. If anybody was around here last year, they saw all the butterflies, the hummingbirds. We even had the hummingbirds go over by the torch sunflowers, which I'm going to do along the side of the house here too, especially around the chimney. And then I'm going to get some sunflowers on the edge there, just beyond the hill and going down the embankment by the house here. Not all the way out, but enough where we get some sunflowers growing up there. Because I can't go down there and cut the grass. My knees are not good enough to do that, period. So we'll have sunflowers, you know, along the edge of the embankment over there, up to probably this last tree here. And then sunflowers all around the garden. And like I said, the best thing I can tell you is when I do my chemtrail videos, I swear a lot because, you know, they don't care about you. They do not. George Carlin says they don't give a... No, I'm going to swear just for this one sake. George Carlin says they don't give a fuck about you. They don't give a fuck about you. They don't give a fuck about you. They've been spraying these guys for 40, 50, 60 years or better because of that reason, okay? So they sprayed out here earlier today. There's one of them where I'm going to use the word. I'm not even going to call it swear anymore because it's just a descriptive name of what they are. If I can get up there. There's a spray bastard right there. I'm holding the camera steady as I can. He's going northeast. You know, and they just want to make sure that the sky's got a good covering. And like I said, that stuff up there rains down into the ground. So no matter what you think you're going to do, you know, we're doing the best what we feel we can. It's better than the crap you're going to buy in the store. It's not the best. It's not perfect, but it's better, I feel. I know I'm putting heirloom seeds in there. I'm giving it as best as I can. Well water, which is somewhat contaminated. Everything is contaminated in this country, all over the world, basically. Except for the elite people who have their stuff grown in greenhouses, I guarantee you. And they have the same stuff I have, but theirs gets purified water, or pure water. And the minerals and nutrients that they've depleted over all the farmland throughout the country for like the last two, I'd say at least the last century. Since about 1903, it went from like 90% nutrients and minerals in your ground, probably down to about 20% or less right now, all over this country. So you can laugh and think nothing of it and die a good sickly death in the next 2 to 10 years, maybe, if you get that far. Your grandchildren will not have anything. Trust me. Your grandchildren will not have anything unless something major changes. And if we don't have that summer rage, which I really sincerely predict this summer, 2016, in the United States of America, the United States is a corporation for the idiots that don't realize that still. Few of you don't realize it. Most people do realize it now. The United States is a corporation. It used to be a 10 square mile in D.C., but they've, through fraud and just corruption and illegal movement maneuvers, they've got federal buildings all over the country saying, well, that's our land. That's our land. Federal land, that's our building. You know, it's all BS. It is BS. But you're okay with it because, again, listen to all the people you hear off in the distance yelling. You hear them? Yeah, me neither. You know why? Because most people are just too stupid. No, I shouldn't say stupid. They're ignorant. They don't pay attention because they've been taught not to study. They teach you English. They teach you English. They teach you history. It may not be true history or real history, but it's the history they teach you in a public school that, by law, you have to go to. Why would that be like a law to go to a school that's going to indoctrinate you with false crap? Think about that one. Anyway, I just want to get this on here. I do all this ranting all the time. I got people on two-faced novel. Let's see if you visit that. Or two-faced comic book doing chemtrails and all that. And again, I swear on almost all my videos about chemtrails because, again, it's serious stuff that most of you are just too ignorant or stupid to realize that they are killing you like a bug. They are. But you're okay with that. So, you know, gosh, I just want to be left alone. I want to be able to live a decent life and be left alone. The thing is, if a government has got to use these people, these men, I guess you'd call them, and maybe even women, that have a piece of metal on their chest and they have a loaded weapon on them to enforce a law, what kind of law would that have to be that they have to enforce it under threat? Think about that sometimes, you know? I mean, I'd say about 90% of the people in this country are not bad people. I mean, and the others, the ones that are bad, I'd say maybe 5% of those are really bad, and then 3% are really, really bad. You know, there's people who are going to steal and all that because they just don't realize better or have been taught not to be self-sufficient. But, you know, they got these laws to enslave you, and like I said, all I can say is you're okay with it because I don't hear anything. I've not seen a person say anything, not one thing against it. You know, so, heaven help you because I won't. I'm doing what I can for my wife and I and our little Dougies, and, you know, I want to be left alone. I'm not threatening anybody, but I'm not rolling over either. The smell of urine-soaked panties will not be in my face. You might wear them, but I'm not going to be around them. Yeah, so there you go. That's all I can say.